Hello friends. In this review, we will talk about a multi-port uninterruptible power supply, UPS, for low voltage loads with voltages of 5, 9, and 12 volts, as well as devices powered via power over Ethernet, POE, of 24 and 48 volts. We'll check whether the declared power of the ports matches the actual power and measure the actual capacity of the batteries. Such devices are very helpful during power outages, providing power to routers, servers, controllers, and smart home gateways, IP cameras, and other critical infrastructure. Additionally, they can be used in other cases, for example, for autonomous lighting. Before we start, as usual, I ask you to like this video, it helps promote it on YouTube, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so before. Device type, direct current uninterruptible power supply. Battery capacity, 20,800 mAh, or 74.88 Wh. Power supply, electrical grid, from 100 to 240 volts, or DC power supply 12 to 24 volts, 3 amps. Maximum output power, 60 watts. Output connectors. 5 volts, 2 USB, 1 DC, current up to 2.5 amps. 1 DC connector with switching 9 to 12 volts, current up to 2 amps. For DC connectors at 12 volts, maximum current up to 5 amps. Gigabit LAN input and output with guaranteed POE power, switchable between 24 or 48 volts. Current 1.2 or 0.6 amps respectively. Dimensions 214 by 150 by 85 millimeters. I purchased two such uninterruptible power supplies during a sale in November 2023. Taking into account the discounts and shipping, they cost me just over $112. The device comes in a large box made of dense cardboard with bright printing. The box was sealed in plastic, indicating that it had not been opened since leaving the factory. On the bottom side, there is a sticker listing the brief technical specifications I've already mentioned. There are also more powerful versions at 100 and 120 watts. Everything is packed quite well, with the bulk of the box occupied by the uninterruptible power supply itself. Alongside it, there is a box with accessories and a manual. Here's everything that was found inside. As you can see, there are quite a lot of cables, which is good considering the number of ports in the power of the UPS. I'll say a few words about them. The cable for connecting to the electrical network, the type of plug is specified when ordering. The device does not need a separate power supply, although there is a possibility to operate from one. There is also a special metal panel included, which can be mounted on the wall, and the UPS can be installed on it, for which it has a special slot. Several cables equipped with standard round DC connectors of 5.5 by 2.5 millimeters were found in the set. Standard, one input, one output, splitters, one input, two outputs, and for three outputs. There is also a 1 meter extension cable, in case the standard length is not enough. For cases when consumers need a different type of connector, there are three adapters included, from 5.5 by 2.5 millimeters to 5.5 by 2.1, 3.5 by 1.35 millimeters, and one with a 90-degree angle connector. Additional adapters can be purchased separately if needed, and I will leave a link in the description. The manual is in English. It contains a description of the main features of the device and accessories included. It is common for all versions, 60, 100, or 120 watts. According to it, the models also differ from each other by the screen. It can be a simple segment LED indicator or a screen displaying various parameters. Let's move on to the main subject of this review. It is a fairly large black plastic box. The connectors are located on the longer sides. On the top part, there is a power button, and in my case, a screen. Alternatively, there might be a segment indicator for the charge level. The screen displays various parameters. Battery voltage. Power of connected loads. Load and percentage. Mains voltage. At the bottom, there are icons for different operating modes. On this side, there are four of the most powerful connectors, designed for 12 volts and a current of up to 5 amps, that is, the maximum power of 60 watts. Next, there is a 2-amp connector with the possibility of setting the voltage to 9 or 12 volts and input connectors, around 1 for the DC power supply with a voltage of 12 to 24 volts and for the 220-volt network. On the other side, there are network gigabit connectors, a LAN input and a PV output with the possibility of setting the voltage to 24 or 48 volts. In other words, the device acts as a PV injector with guaranteed power. A cable from the router is connected to it, and it outputs the network with power. Also on this side are two USB and a round DC connector at 5 volts. On the bottom side, as I already mentioned, there is a special slot intended for installation on the metal panel that comes with the set. Before I move on to the disassembly, I'd like to mention one more thing. In one of the two UPS units I bought, something was clearly rattling inside the case. A characteristic knocking sound was heard. After opening the case, it turned out that two of the four screws holding the main board had fallen out during transportation. Interestingly, according to reviews, I wasn't the only one with this problem. Additionally, the rest of the screws were also quite loosely held. This was not because they were loosely screwed in, but due to the holes being too large for them. It was impossible to tighten them properly without clamping something. Therefore, I recommend disassembling the case immediately, checking all the screws, and securing them well. In the lower part, there is a battery consisting of 8 18,650 cells. This is good because they are easy to replace, and if desired, the capacity can be increased. The configuration is 4S2P, i.e., a nominal voltage of 14.4 volts, based on 3.6 volts per cell. The declared capacity of each element is 2,600 milliamp hours, or 9.36 watt hours. The total capacity of the battery is 20,800 milliamp hours, as stated in the specifications, or 74.88 watt hours. Apparently, balancing is provided, as in addition to the two pairs of power wires, there are three thin wires going to the battery for connection at the points of serial connection. This is also a plus. I try to make my reviews as objective as possible, so now about the unpleasant part. One of the two UPS units I bought, the one in which two screws were rattling, turned out to be non-functional. I mean, none of its ports had any output voltage. It turned on, and the screen showed the voltage on the batteries. Moreover, it even charged them, which I specifically checked. However, there was no output. Unfortunately, the dispute period had expired, as I took too long to check them after receiving them. Therefore, my second recommendation is to check immediately, so in case of any issues, you can demand a refund. The second unit turned out to be all right. All the screws were in place, but I still disassembled it and secured everything, and all ports were functional. I will try to figure out what the problem is with the first one. If I manage to fix it, great. If not, I will use it for some DIY project. Now it's time to move on to testing. First, let's conduct a power test of the ports. According to the manual, for 5 volts, it's 2.5 amps, for the switchable 9 to 12 volt port, 2 amps, and for the 12 volt ports, 5 amps, for the 60 watt version. All measurements are with the external power disconnected. Let's start with 9 volts 2 amps. There's a slight sag, but it's all good. The power shown on the screen is higher than the actual, by about 1.5 watts. I switched to 12 volts. There's a small sag. The screen also overestimates by the same value. Power 40% of the maximum. No mains power connected. Voltage on the batteries. The most powerful ports, 12 volts 5 amps. Voltage sag, by 0.6 volts. Power almost matches the actual. Load 95%. No external power. Batteries. In reality, the declared power is slightly exaggerated. Test at 5 volts, 2.5 amps. Everything is excellent here, no sags, holds the declared power. Power over Ethernet 48 volts backup. I checked with the network coordinator Smlite SLSB-06. I connected a cable from the router to the UPS and from the PV port to the coordinator, which now serves not only for data transmission but also for power. The coordinator started up. Everything works normally. Besides the convenience of connection, all with one cable, in this case, uninterrupted operation is also ensured in the event of an external power outage. According to the screen readings, the battery charges up to a voltage of 16.5 volts. This is slightly more than 4.1 volts per cell. I will be testing on one of the 12-volt ports at a current of 4 amps. This is approximately 48 watts. On average, to back up a smart home control center, a router, an energy-efficient Intel-based server with a coordinator, it requires around 15 to 20 watts. My system, which includes a router, an additional gigabit switch, 3 servers, and 2 coordinators, consumes about 40 watts. So, I took a substantial margin. At such a current, the sag is just over 3/10 of a volt, within normal limits. The actual power on load is just over 46.5 watts. In this case, the screen showed a slightly lower value, 46.1 watts. The load is 76% of the maximum. In my opinion, this is an optimal level. If your load is closer to 100%, it makes sense to install either a second or a more powerful UPS. The voltage on the batteries at the start of the testing was 15.9 volts. Checking after half an hour, the voltage remains at the same level, 25 watt hours of energy delivered. The voltage on the batteries dropped to 14.1 volts. Shortly before shutting down, the UPS screen starts to flicker. This is a photo just before the shutdown. An hour has passed since the start of the test. Here it can be seen that the voltage level remained almost the same as at the beginning of the test. This is a plus. The voltage on the batteries at this moment was 12.9 volts. Right after this photo was taken, it dropped to 12.8 and the UPS turned off. Thus, the voltage per cell was 3.2 volts. This is with a margin. It would have been possible to discharge a bit more, although it wouldn't have made a significant difference. The result was 1 hour and almost 1 minute. A total of 47.4 watt hours of energy was delivered, which is just over 63% of the claimed capacity. Even taking into account conversion losses, this is low. It should be at least 75 to 80%. By the way, in the reviews, I found mentions of measurements by other users. They wrote about values of 50 watt hours. At lower powers, it would be approximately the same. If we talk about the consumption of an average smart home control center, the UPS can provide around 3 hours of autonomous operation. Now let's check how the device behaves after power is restored. Currently, the UPS is fully discharged and turned off. After power is supplied, it turns on automatically, voltage appears on its ports immediately, and charging begins. The voltage on the fully discharged batteries at this point is 13.7 volts. I connected the UPS to a managed outlet with energy monitoring. It showed a consumed power of 27 watts. This means the charging current is around 2 amps. After it was fully charged, its own consumption, without load, is around 3 watts. As we can see, there are both positive and negative aspects here. Let's start with the positives: a large number of ports, commonly used in in-demand voltages, 5, 9, and 12 volts. The presence of power over Ethernet with a voltage of 48 volts is actually quite rare. Next, there seems to be balancing on the battery elements, and the power of the ports generally matches the declared values. Automatic turning on when external power is supplied, the ability to work from both AC mains and a 12 to 24 volt power supply. The screen displays key parameters. The negatives include one of the UPS units being non-functional, possibly due to the screws falling out, which is also a downside. Next, it's worth noting the capacity is significantly below the declared, and according to reviews, this is not just an issue with my unit. Yes, the batteries are easy to replace, and there's room to try to fit 12 instead of 8, but one would expect to get what is advertised. The device is overall quite good and convenient, especially if you need to back up something on PoE, but it's important to understand what you can realistically expect from it. That's all. I hope this video was helpful and interesting to you. I would appreciate your likes as they help promote this video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. In the video description, I'll leave links to the stores where you can purchase this uninterruptible power supply. Additionally, you'll find links to reviews on the topic, a link to my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and a group for discussing smart home questions. Join us, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. Until we meet again. Peace to everyone.